A contract may have a cancellation clause which permits the parties involved in the contract to cancel it before it's due to expire. Cancellation is, with simple words, an ability to cancel a participation in an insurance or reinsurance contract before it is due to expire. The contract period is normally defined in the contract. And if a contract is cancelled by one of the parties before the expiry date, it is then cancellation of the contract. A contract may have a cancellation clause which permits the parties involved in the contract to cancel it before it's due to expire, and also stipulates the conditions for cancellation, which is affected by sending a cancellation notice. The clause may provide for a return of premium in respect of unused portion of the contract. The cancellation of the contract on the continuous contracts is supported by this notice of cancellation. Here, I would like to talk briefly about what a continuous contract is. It is a contract that remains in effect until both parties mutually agree to terminate it, or one of the parties sends the other one a notice of cancellation. A notice of cancellation is a means to notify the other participants of the intention to withdraw from the treaty. This notice is used only for withdrawal from continuous reinsurance contracts, which are typically eligible for cancellation or renewal once a year. A notice of cancellation also allows all parties the periodic opportunity to assess the contract and either renew it or withdraw from it. Most reinsurance arrangements allow for these assessments once a year. Both the insured entity and the reinsurer have the right to issue a notice of cancellation. Doing so gives them up to a 90-day window in which they can formally cancel the contract. So far, I have mentioned what is cancellation and how this process works. I now would like to briefly touch on the accounting perspective of a cancellation of a reinsurance contract, as this is a very important topic to be considered too. Cancellation of a reinsurance contract in accounting can be in two ways. First way is run-off basis, which means that the ability of the reinsurer under policies which became effective under the treaty prior to the cancellation date shall continue until the expiration date of each policy. And the second way is cut-off basis, which means that the liability of the reinsurer under policies which became effective under the treaty prior to the cancellation date shall not continue after set cancellation date. Those two methods will be explained more in detail in the other videos of the reinsurance tutorials.